friends, welcome back to Nurse's Nook and Corner. Today, let me learn on the most important topic that is used in clinical setting at times of emergency, that is airway management. Come, let's see in detail. Before going into the topic, if you didn't subscribe the channel, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the uploaded videos. Let this year 2021 begin with new dreams to achieve, new days to work hard, new desires and new ways to learn more and more. Wish you all happy new year. Definition of airway management. Airway management includes a set of maneuvers, medical procedures and devices for the purpose of maintaining or restoring ventilation in a patient. It includes both basic and advanced airway management. The basic airway management are airway maneuvers, abdominal thrust and back blows. The advanced airway management includes supraglottic devices, infraglottic devices and the surgical method. The supraglottic devices are oropharyngeal airway and the nasopharyngeal airway. The advanced airway, which includes the infraglottic devices, are laryngeal mask airway, the combi tube and the endotracheal intubation. The surgical methods in advanced airway includes tracheostomy and cricothyroidectomy. Let's see in detail one by one. First of all, let's see about the basic airway management, the airway maneuvers. The first one is head tilt chin lift maneuver. Tilt the patient heads back by pushing down on the forehead. Place the tips of your index and middle finger under the chin and pull up on the mandible. This lifts the tongue away from the posterior pharynx and improves airway patency. And you should be sure to pull up only on the bony part of the mandible. Pressure to the soft tissue of the neck may obstruct the airway. Next maneuver is jaw thrust maneuver. Stand at the head of the stretcher and place your palms on the patient temples and your fingers under the mandibular rami. In patients with possible cervical spine injury, avoid extending the neck. Lift the mandible upward with your fingers at least until the lower incisors are higher than the upper incisor. This maneuver lifts the tongue along with the mandible, thus relieving upper airway obstruction. And you should also be sure to pull or push up only on the bony parts of the mandible. Pressure to the soft tissue of neck may obstruct the airway. The next airway maneuver is abdominal thrust maneuver. This airway maneuver is done when the patient airway suddenly gets blocked either fully or partly so they can't breathe. The steps for abdominal thrust are: stand behind the person who's choking, place your arms around their waist and bend them forward. Clench fist and place it right above their belly button. Put the other hand on the top of your fist and pull sharply inward and upward. Repeat this movement up to 5 times. And it should be done until the airway is cleared. The next airway maneuver is back blow maneuvers. So stand behind the client and slightly to one side. Support their chest with one hand. Give up to 5 sharp blows between their shoulder blades with the heel of your hand. Check if the blockage has cleared. If not, give up to 5 thrusts. Next, let's see about the advanced airways and how to measure the different kind of airways. Next, let's see about the oropharyngeal airway. The oropharyngeal airway are of different sizes and it is measured from the midpoint of incisors to the angle of mandible. The oropharyngeal airway is J-shaped tube, fits over the tongue to hold the soft hypopharyngeal, use if no gag reflex is present, not to be used in a conscious or semi-conscious individual as they may use the gag reflex to put it out. OPA is used in individuals who are at risk for developing airway obstruction from the tongue or from relaxed upper airway muscle. These are the various sizes of oropharyngeal airway, the color codings and their sizes. The most commonly used color coding for adult is yellow and green. That is size 2 and size 3 are most commonly used for the adults. The next supraglottic device is the nasopharyngeal airway. The nasopharyngeal airway is measured from the lateral edge of the nostril to the tragus of ear. Description about nasopharyngeal airway. The NPA is a soft rubber or plastic uncuffed tube that provides a conduit for airflow between the nas and the pharynx. It is used as an alternative to an OPA in individuals who need the basic airway management urgent. The NPA may be used in conscious as well as in semi-conscious individual and if gag reflex is present. Avoid placing NPAs in individual with obvious facial fractures. These are the various nasopharyngeal airway sizes. It starts from 12 French to 36 French. The next is the infraglottic devices, that is laryngeal mask airway. The laryngeal mask airway, also called as LMA, is an advanced airway alternative to endotracheal intubation and provides comparable ventilation. So the parts of laryngeal mask airway are, it has a cuff and aperture bar, mask, airway tube, valve, inflation indication balloon, inflation line and the airway connector. How to insert a laryngeal mask airway? First, hold the LMA like a pen with index finger of the dominant hand at the junction of the mask and the tube as shown in the picture. Then, slowly progress the movement of the tube into the mouth as it's shown in the picture. The next infraglottic device is the endotracheal airway. The endotracheal tube is an advanced airway. It is a specific type of tracheal tube that is inserted through the mouth. It is most technically difficult airway to place. However, it is the most secure airway available. Only experienced providers should perform the endotracheal intubation. The last infraglottic device is the combi tube. Combi tube is also referred to as esophageal tracheal tube, is an advanced airway alternative to endotracheal intubation. This device provides adequate ventilation compared to an ET tube. The combi tube has two separate balloons that must be inflated and two separate ports. The provider must correctly determine which port to ventilate through to provide the adequate oxygenation. The image of combi tube, that is the esophageal tracheal combi tube, has two lumens. One is the pharyngeal lumen and another one is esophageal tracheal lumen. It has a distal cuff to inflate and two balloons would be present. The next advanced airway management are the surgical method. The first one is the tracheostomy tube, which is a small incision is made near the thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage. Tube is inserted so that airway is maintained. The last surgical method is cricothyroidectomy. Let's see the difference between the cricothyroidectomy and the tracheostomy. So cricothyroidectomy, quick, relatively easy stabilization through cricothyroid membrane. Insert any small round airway such as an biro casing. Anesthetic not essential, it is an life saving. Whereas the formal tracheostomy, not usually an emergency, it needs full anesthetic, ideal for temporary or permanent intubation. Hole is cut in the second and third tracheal rings, usually after dividing thyroid isthmus. Inferior thyroid veins can be troublesome. Thank you friends for watching. If you like the video, press the like icon. If you have any doubt, give in the comment box. Follow us in Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook and Twitter.